Please take note, this is not the easy way to create AI forms. Do not come here into Gemini or ChatGPT and give it a prompt like this. I want to build an online form for a real estate website that sells condos in Palm Springs. I'm going to hit submit, and it's going to give me some teaching. Here are some essential form fields, property preferences, form design types. No. I want you to create the form. It's given me some suggestions and form builders. Build it for me in Google Forms, right? This is Google Gemini. Can't you just build it? Unfortunately, I cannot directly create it for you from Google Form. Here's how you create a Google Form. Well, I know how to create a Google Form, but what I don't want to do is go back and forth between Google Forms and my AI bot and copy all of these questions. Well, good news, there is a much easier and much better way to create a form with AI, and Jotform has given it to us. Let's put it to the test. I'm going to paste in here the exact same prompt. Nothing is different from the prompt that I just gave it in Gemini, and I'm going to say create a form. And in just a few seconds, not only has it produced an entire functioning form, something that I could share right away, but it is very, very specific. More than just the title, Palm Springs Condo Inquiry Form. Yes, I'm going to edit that to make it sound a little more specific to my needs. But down below, when we look at the options it's included, number of bedrooms, bathrooms, budget range, even preferred features for a particular apartment or condo, I mean, this thing is ready to go. Now, in most cases, you're going to want to add your logo, or you're going to want to add some other fields. No worries, Jotform has you covered with an incredibly long list of widgets and different options here, so much more than something like Google Forms or many other form builders on the market. On top of that, we can even take payments. I'll show you that in another example, but let's go into the preview here and show you some of the other things that really sets this apart. Number one, I love the formatting here within Jotform. Take, for example, the full name here, the very first question that we're asking here. Not only is it very dynamic, just as I hover my cursor over the different fields, but this full name has broken it out into two short fields. This is something that you can't do within Google Forms. Google Forms would force you to have this last name down below as two short text fields. Here, this makes so much more sense, first name followed by last name. The formatting is so much better. Here we have a phone number, which is formatted, yes, not only for numbers, but a particular digit, a digit length of phone number here. And of course, we can change this helpful text as well. But then down below, when we get to these specific questions, they make sense. If I hover over this drop-down menu, Studio is even one of the options. Everything from studio all the way down to four bedrooms. But watch this. Notice that this is a required field. It's made a number of the options here required, which of course we can change ourselves. But if I click out of this field without making a selection, I really love this within Jotform. It's given me a warning. Not only is this field required, but it's added this sort of pinkish background color. So I am fully aware that I need to fill out this field before submitting the form. I hate having to come down, hitting submit, and then getting a bunch of different arrows, automatically scrolling me back to the top of the form. You got to fill out this, you got to fill out that. Why not give the user some helpful information in the moment? Oh, this is required? Yeah, I'm looking for a two-bedroom apartment, and then I can continue filling out this particular form. So it's little things like that that I find really set Jotform apart. Now I'm going to take it out of preview form mode here and show you something else, which is incredibly helpful here with the AI assistant. And that is called Copilot. Now what Copilot does is allow us to do a number of different things with just a click of a button or if we give it a simple instruction. Of course, we could come here to the form designer and we can customize this form to our heart's content. But with Copilot, I can say, well, let's just change the font. You know, I kind of like Helvetica. Maybe let's go to, no, Helvetica is better than that. Again, I can do these things nice and quickly, nice and easily. I can even add other questions using Copilot as well. So if you don't want to get into all of these features, if you don't want to dive into the styles, themes, and layouts, you can just tell it what you would like to do. Let's go back and give it another test. This time I'm going to say, I want to build an order form with payment for a car detailing business. Okay, so in this case, I want to give it a few options. You'll notice that there's a character counter here. You've got 500 characters to give it a description. I could give it so much more than this if I wanted to. I could give it maybe the different options or so forth, but I just want to get started, right? The main benefit of using AI is to get started quickly, make a few tweaks, and then we can start using it. So I'm going to say create form again. Depending on how detailed your prompt is, depending on how sophisticated it is, of course, this could take up to as much as maybe 20 or 25 seconds. I think that's the longest that I've observed here within Jotform, but it really doesn't take that long at all. Here we are, and we've got our car detailing order form. Again, we've got basic information, name, phone number, email address. Great. Car information, the year of the car required. I love that. It's made that required. Again, I can come in here. I can select that gear icon and say, okay, I don't need to know that. I'm going to do the same thing here with the year of the car. I don't need to know that as a required field. Easy to make those changes. And then down below, services required. So we've got wash, full detail. I mean, this is fantastic. It may even give me some additional ideas that I haven't even thought of for my business. And yes, we can add our own payment methods. Here on the side, if we come back to add elements, and if we select the payments tab, it doesn't matter what you use, I can pretty much guarantee Jotform has you covered. Whether it's Square, PayPal, Stripe, Apple Pay, and Google Pay, almost anything that you could pay with, you're going to find that option here so you can set it up. And then below that, after you've selected your service, you can select your preferred appointment time. And I even love the layout of this. Here we've got a nice big monthly calendar on the left-hand side, and then we'll be able to select our times here. Of course, all of this is editable. You don't have to stay with this option here. You can say what hours you're available and so forth, but it's all built into the form, all by that very simple prompt, right? We used, I think, less than 70 characters to give it a description. It's given me some great stuff to work with. So if you want to build an online form in no time and impress your audience, be sure to check out Jotform's AI form generator. Click the link in the description below so you can start creating your AI forms today. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.